Okay, so welcome to Thread. Today we are going to understand that how to use the multi-threaded activity in Android. And it is very important to understand that how to use the threads properly in Android. And before that, very basic thing about what I wanted to explain to you is that there is a prerequisite for especially this class, and that prerequisite is that you understand the concept of thread, you understand basic concept of thread in Java. Preferably in Java, but any other language if you understand, that is good enough as well. Because we are not going to discuss what is thread, how threads are created in Java and all. We are going to see that how we can use a multi-threaded application in Android world. So that is a kind of a prerequisite for this session. Okay. In this one, there is not much we are using inside the application any thread, but I will develop still a small sample application for the thread and use it. So it is not really directly related to Traveler Assistant, but never mind. Inside the main screen, we'll use this thread, not functionality wise, but in the same project, what we'll do. So what we are going to do is that inside the main application, main screen, if you go here, we are going to create one thread. So in this one, we'll create one thread. Here, we will create one thread. Okay? So our thread creation will be inside main screen itself. And just try to understand that, what is the use of that thread and everything. Now, we'll just create a new text box in the existing main screen XML layout at the top to display a Py value, create a Py class, add code in main screen activity to load image from a network resource using. Instead of this one, we'll not do this one. We'll do this one. So this is also a threaded one. So we'll use Py. So what I'm going to do is that, start with the basics of the thread. So let us go there. And this will be overview, the thread basics, the thread rule. There are two special classes called special Android classes to write thread application. Okay. So we'll look into both of this, and the concept of looper we'll try to understand, and the multi-threaded consideration. It is assumed that you know the fundamental concept of thread in Java. We here discuss the Android aspect of thread handling. So that's pretty much what we are going to do today. Not very complicated. We'll just see that how it works. So before we start, why do we need a thread? So here is, let us assume there is a button, and when you click, it is start calculating a Py value. So there is some method called calculate Py. But let us assume it takes very long. And then after it calculates the value, it is going to store in a text box. But while it is calculating that pi value, you cannot do anything on that screen. There is nothing, because it will hold that screen, and there is very difficult to do anything. If there is another button or another click event, you can't do it, because it is waiting for this one to complete. It will wait for this one to complete until it comes to here. So it will not do that, and it will also stop your main thread from doing anything. So what is the solution to that? The best solution is that we create a thread. So if you have a wrong running application, which should not block the regular progress of your application, then you should use thread. So what you could do is that we'll create a thread like this. Here. So what we are going to do is that we will put this whole activity inside a new thread. So we'll create a new thread like this. A new thread. What this means is that when you click that button, it will keep doing its things, and at the same time you can click another button, do something else on that application, it will not stop you. So let us go start and develop this application and see that how it works.